Hi everybody, welcome back to Kelly Plays, and today we're giving This War of Mine a go. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I've played this game a lot. I'm not gonna say I'm the best at it, because I definitely am not, but I have played it a few times because I really enjoy it. It's a sort of a survival game, sort of a building game. Essentially, you're in a war zone. You are stuck with a bunch of other survivors who each have their own specific skills. You've got to feed your group, you've got to keep them warm, you've got to build various things around the house to make survival easier, and you've got to go out and scavenge in various dangerous situations. Now, this game's come a long way from when I first started playing it. It now has modding centres, a workshop story, I don't even know what that is. You can customise your game so that you certain areas are available, some aren't. The difficulty is higher or lower. And yeah, it's a really good game. I've replayed this a whole bunch of times now, and each time tried to better my ending compared to what I had the previous go. So let's go for another try, which would start me on a new game. Now, in this, you get to choose who you would like playing with you. So you can either choose... you get to have four people, I believe, eventually. So you can either choose from the start exactly who your four people will be, or you can start by yourself and see who else comes to join you. So, I mean, I could cheat a little bit because there is like an Uber team that you can choose. There's a couple of good teams, but there's like one team that I choose every time that gives you like the best fighter, the best cook, the best mechanic, and things like that. But I don't want to do that. I want to actually challenge myself. So what I'll do is, this is new apparently, starting with Roman and Katia. So we'll give that a go, just to see what happens. You'll lose your current progress. Yeah, go for it. Let's see what these two characters... I know what they individually bring, so we'll see how they interact together. Day one. Fuck the war. And I love this game style, like the look of it is just so gorgeous. Oh, this house is different to the one I usually play in, I think. Oh no, maybe not. No, I don't think it is actually. I think it is possibly the same. But yeah, here we are. There's Roman, there's Katia. And job number one, if I... this part of the city, besieged city, has been spared from the worst destruction until recently, which attracts many homeless survivors from other neighbourhoods. Spelling easy game, robbers descend on them, in force to prey on their misery. Fleeing from a thug, Katia has been saved by Roman, a former militia member. Later, her quick thinking and press badge saved them both when they stumbled upon an army picket. They decide to ride it out together, despite their severe differences in their views. Okay. So, first things first is... So we've got Roman, who's trained in combat. We're going to get him to work clearing that. And for Katia... Oh. Okay, so this is our things. Let's grab them all. Katia can have a look. Can she pull the wood off this door? Oh, she's wounded as well. So you can check out their bio. So Katia, she's a coffee drinker. So if we give her coffee, she'll be happier. I grew up in this city, but I went abroad to study and started working as a reporter. I've been away for years. When the troubles escalated into a war, I was picked to write reports on it. I'd have volunteered anyway. I was so anxious to check on my parents, but it was too late. I found my house in ruin, my family disappeared, and I've been looking for them ever since. That's quite sad. Oh, Roman's already cleared all that, so let's send him upstairs to clear this rubble. Katia's gone through there. So we've got a medical box there, but it's empty. Got a table down here we can rummage through. More materials, might as well take them. What do we got over here? Materials. Can we put materials in there? No. See, that's the downside, is once we have our things in this box here, if we get raided, this is what they draw from when they steal things. So in some respects, I don't want to take this stuff, but in others, I'm going to need it to build stuff. So we might as well just grab it. Let's have a look. So we got Rome. I never thought I'd end up running and hiding from my buddies. That's not how things turned out. But that's how things turned out. We were like brothers, and now I'm a dead man to them. My crew had ruled the hood since we were teens until just before the war. Then some of us got drafted, like my best friend Leon. Others like me volunteered for the militia. It was going to be the ultimate showdown, and every one of us wanted a piece of the action. So that's Roman trained in combat, and he's a smoker. Okay, so we got that cupboard there. Might as well clear this while we're here. Actually, let's go see if there's anything we can build yet. Oh, she's limping a bit. So we need beds. Oh good, we can make one. Where to make it? Drag to place on an empty destination. Can we place them up here? I mean, ideally we want to keep them all in the same area so that when we start doing heating, we can keep them all relatively warm. I don't know if that's how it works, but that's certainly how I'm going to look at it. I think this is slightly different to the previous house I play, and maybe it changes it each time. No, we're going to keep the beds upstairs because having a bed near the door so that whoever's in it can answer the door if needed is actually really useful. So we're going to put this person right at the bottom of the stairs. I'm sure they massively appreciate that. Place. She's not doing great, but having a bed means she can lie down and it will help her recover, which is good. Meanwhile, Roman's still hard at work up here. Getting through that rubble. So what we can do is we can let her rest during the day and then hopefully she'll be awake enough at night to stay guard while Roman goes out and scavenges. One bed. No, don't get a bed, Roman. Sorry, I thought I was selecting Cassia. Right. Recovering. Good. Roman's almost through this massive pile of rubble. Not sure this was the best house to choose, guys, but yeah, each to their own, I guess. Rather chilly inside. Oh, I don't want to have to think about heating yet. That's loads of work. Cool. More materials, including water. Always useful. Let's go rummage through this. Oh, there's a door there I could have gone through as well. Oh well, there's loads of stuff I could look at the moment, so let's just keep looking. Rummage, rummage. More materials. What about in here? Anything? No, just a room. That's fine. We've got a chair. Let's go see if there's anything so we can make. If we double click, he should run. Just straight through the bed. Okay. Oh, we can make a heater. That's good. We can make somewhere to cook, but we don't have anything to cook yet, so that's kind of pointless. Okay, well, it seems logical that we make this, seeing as they're already complaining that it's cold. We'll place it. Where should we place it? I want to keep my workbenches both very close together, so I guess I'll pop it in here. Maybe. No, fuck it. I'm guessing there's still space for a workbench there, right? Maybe? Perhaps? Can we put it upstairs? I don't know if it matters. Like, if I don't place it right in the middle of the house, does that mean only like one room gets warmed? I don't know. Anyway, let's just build the damn thing. Do 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 do. Hard at work. He's got a little skull on the back of- Oh, I can zoom in. He's got a little skull on the back of his jacket, it looks like. Oh no, no, it's a peace sign. That's complete opposite to a skull. Cool. So now we've got a heater. What else can we build? Not much. I can make some fuel, which I guess is useful. So we're gonna need it. It's still 14 degrees, so it's not exactly freezing. Okay, so the door's locked there. What about this door down here? Whoosh. Okay. Oh, is this a rummageable pile? It is. Excellent. I'll take the lot. And then we'll go... Can we get through this door? We can. Okay, so there's another big pile of rubble. Might as well pull the bars off this door and go through this little table first and see if we can make ourselves a shovel. Because that'll make getting through this rubble 100% easier. Oh, we got some lock picks. That's good, so we can get through that other door, that locked one, and a bunch of other bits and pieces. Cool. Now let's quickly go make some tools before the day ends. We're getting close to the end of the day. Oh, I need a tool station to be able to make tools. Okay. Metal workshop. Can I just place that next to it? Yes, I can. Excellent. Okay. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to make any tools before the day ends, which is annoying. I would have liked to have taken a... what's it called? A shovel with me. But time is really ticking by. So I don't think we're going to get that chance. Yeah, it's almost 7:30 now, so... What do we need for these things? Just lots of metal and some wood. I'm just gonna... You know what? I'm just gonna end the day now, because we're not gonna get anything done in, like, the few minutes that there are available. So she's wounded, but she's not tired, so what... Yeah, I think actually on the first night, everything's usually quite quiet, so we'll leave Katia. She's a better scavenger, because while she's not as strong as Roman... She can carry more things. So it's a shame that she's not up for it, but we'll manage. So what have we got? We've got a ruined block of flats with lots of food, huge amounts of materials, some meds, huge amounts of weapons, and lots of parts. We've got the garage, or garage, as you may want to call it. Lots of food, materials, some meds, lots of parts. Possible trade caution advised. Okay, so there's potentially people living there. So we want to avoid that, I guess. Decrepit squat. Inhabited by the homeless. They've been struggling. Huge amounts of materials, lots of weapons, lots of parts. Well, at the moment, we have no food. So we're going to go to the ruined block of flats. We're going to take, I guess, one lockpick with us in case if we encountered a locked door, like, straight away, we're going to be screwed. So we'll take one lockpick. And let's see where that gets us. Okay. So now we're going to go on our first scavenging trip. And when you scavenge, your actions make noises. So, for example, when he starts rummaging, did you see the little, like, ripple that comes around? I'll grab everything for now. Yeah, that... Oh, I should have left something in there. Then come back and sort of dump things there and collect it at the end. But yeah, the little ripple implies the noise you're making. You can also see where is visible. Like, the lit area is what is visible to you and to others, so other people would be able to see me at the moment if they were stood in this visible area. Okay, so we got a bunch of stuff here. We'll take the... We'll take all the stuff we want, but leave the stuff we're not too bothered about, so that next time... I doubt we're going to be able to carry everything. It means when we come back, I can just have everything have... left it there in that little section, so I don't have to go running through the house trying to collect everything. This baby carriage isn't empty. A few objects I scattered around inside. A rattle, a smiling red crab, well worn by baby teeth, a feeding bottle half full of congealed mass. That was probably baby formula. Someone must have left in a terrible rush, or maybe they didn't need them anymore. Nice. Let's have a look through this box. Stuff. Take the cigarettes. Take the materials. Oh, I'm already out of space. I know we don't need that. Weapon parts. Well, we don't have any others at the moment, so that's not particularly useful. We don't need the tobacco leaf yet, because we've got one cigarette there. We will take that mechanical part. We'll take the electric doodad for now. You can also peek through doors like this. And it will show you a slice of the room, which increases a little the longer you look through. So the room's empty, so it's safe to go in. Let's have a little rummage. A ramage. Oh gosh, loads of materials. Well, we can take two more of that, because then we've got a full stack. Can't take any more of the other things at present. I think keeping hold of the food is most important. More tobacco leaves, but we can't make anything with those yet. Standard roll-up cigarette. What's this? Quality roll-up, so that's better. Take those, because apparently we can stack those. We can stack these. Books, you can just actually sit in the HQ that you've got and read. Which is quite good actually, it keeps them happy. So what I'm going to do is drop that wood for now. Take these books. I really want to take the coffee because, you know, the other lass is really into her coffee. Actually, they've not been going too long so far. So what we'll do is we'll leave the cigarette and the coffee behind. And, check out some other stuff instead. So this room's got bars on it, so we can't get in there. That looks like a skeleton in that chair. Lovely. Right, it's a big pile of rubble here. Let's have a look through that. It's only 11 PM, so we've got a long time. Oh, vegetables. We'll take that. That's everything we can carry at present. I think there was one of the other things still had a book in it, so we could still maybe stack books. Takes a few more of those. Let's go back to the top floor. It's another set of iron bars there, so we can't get through that way. Excellent, another veggie. More wood. So there are loads of materials here, so we're definitely going to have to come back here tomorrow. If we can get a hacksaw, even better. There was a little bathroom here as well, but we can't get to there because this room is blocked off with bars. So let's run back down. Running, as you can see, makes this huge little area of sound around you. So if there was anyone else around, they would definitely be hearing me. And things like hacksawing through the doors makes a lot of noise as well. Okay, so maybe there wasn't. Maybe I imagined it. Is it in this one? Yes, there we go. Cool. So we got a fair few good things. There's not much point hanging around any longer. We can't carry anything else, so we'll just run to exit. As you can see there, you can swap to weapons as well if you encounter anyone and try to kill them or scare them off, I guess. Doesn't have to be death. Okay, let's go see how Katia is doing. Day 2. Honey, I'm home. Hello, look at all this stuff. I wish I could bring so much every night. We've been raided. Great. You know how I said I don't think you get raided on the first night? Clearly I was wrong. What did they take? Oh my god, they stole so much! And Katia's like severely wounded. Oh my god, they took basically everything we had. Right, can I make a cooker? Because we're gonna need food. Yes. Thank Christ. Right, let's make that. Let's put it up in the kitchen just because it seems logical. Because if we make a cooker, then eating this food, it will go further. You can like combine a scrap of meat with vegetables and make, I guess, stew instead of just munching it straight down your face. We really need a second bed, but yeah, right now it's not so important. She's severely wounded, which is not great. Let's check her bio. I gotta be strong. My friends have it rough as well, but it hurts so much. We got no medicine either. Oh, no, no, no. Sorry, Katia. You stay in bed. You recover, sweetheart. Oh, no. To make simple cooked food, we have everything but water. We could even make multiple meals, but we need water. The fuel we can make. Oh, that's so frustrating. Okay. Right. Let's... It's easier to fall ill when it's so cold. It's not that cold. Come on, bro. We don't have enough to... We don't have enough to make anything. We can't even make a freaking shovel. Let's see what else we can make by the basic workbench. Nothing. Cool. So, it is gonna have to be a rummage by hand, I'm afraid, Roman. What's his bio say? How am I to survive if thugs are trying to kill me and take my things? I feel you, bro. At least we've got a lockpick so we can get into this. Admittedly, it would have been easier to use a crowbar because then we don't... A lockpick breaks as soon as you use it, so they're all single use. Whereas a crowbar you can use multiple times, but them's the breaks, I guess. So he's just going to have to scrabble through it all by hand. With a sigh. Take your time, bro. This is super fun to watch. This game is incredible. And like I said, it varies depending on the characters you have as well. Because their interactions will vary. The interactions they have with other people in the game will vary. Their skills will make certain elements of the game easier or harder. Like, Roman's not usually a character I choose to have in my team, despite him being good at combat, because I try to avoid combat. So it also depends on your game style. If you want to go out and beat the shit out of everyone you come across, then yeah, having a guy who's good at fighting is probably going to help you. Oh, he's almost through. I should sleep off the last night. I know, buddy, I know, but we gotta do this. Let's see if we got anything useful in here. Please be something good. Medicine! And a little bit of water and more books. Okay, well, that's better than nothing. Let's... Can I give medicine to Katy? Damn it, there are no smokes left. There are more important things than cigarettes, sir. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll get him to get to work on this next rubble pile. I'm gonna get Katya to go and take some of these pills, because boy oh boy does she need them. She's doing really badly. Like, usually when you double click something, the character will run. She's not able to run. She's hungry, severely wounded, and sad. Well, hopefully the painkillers will do something. I feel fine. Let's save the meds for later. Oh. Okay, so maybe I need bandages because it's a wound as opposed to sickness, I guess. Oh well. I'll just have to carry on with Roman trying to get people. I should have done that pile of stuff. Oh no, that door's locked, isn't it? I've got a lockpick. Oh. I'm a dummy. I can't help it. I'm sorry. Do-do-do-do-do. So what else do we know about Roman? Nothing. I know he's stressed out because he has no cigarettes. Yeah, I love the style of this game. These sort of pencil... Oh, excuse me. These pencil sketches, you can choose to go really soft or really heavy on them. So I've chosen soft because I quite like the contrast between the pencil-y backgrounds and the more high-res foregrounds. You can choose to have the entire game really sort of sketchy looking. Oh yeah, this is totally different. My other place used to have a treehouse out the back, so this place is really different from there. I should eat something. I know, friend. Okay, well, I don't really want either of them to go out. He's tired. She's wounded. Oh gosh. I'm gonna have to have him guard while she sleeps again. And just hope that she's better by tomorrow so that Roman can actually get some sleep. Yeah, we're gonna have to stay. Stay for one night. Day three. We've been raided, but... Oh, someone tried to rob us. They were just a couple of scavengers, so we managed to fend them off. Phew. Too bad we had no weapons. None of us was wounded and the attackers didn't steal anything. So Roman's good as a guard. She's slightly sick, severely wounded. So she definitely needs pills. What does Roman have to say? I was at the front line since the shit got serious. My unit was always the first to go in and the last to get out. After I lost a quarter of my men, the elders decided we need some R&R. That's how I wound up in Pogoren, where all was quiet. It was not to last. Wow. This guy's had a pretty tough time though. Can we make any food? Oh, we haven't got enough water! Damn it. Okay. Let's see if we can get this door open. I'm sorry, Roman, I know you're tired. It's locked, right. Well, back to work down here then. So she's on meds. Once the hospital is open, because the hospital is the location you go to. I might have to send Katia there if she doesn't start getting better soon. Has she got anything else to say? No. So it seems that maybe Katia is very against the war, whereas Roman, having volunteered for the militia, I'm guessing, is more pro-war. You know, she perhaps wishes that no one was fighting at all, whereas he thinks that the side he is on is worth fighting for. We really don't have much stuff. This is depressing. We have only one chair. We have one bed, but could use more. It's hard to get a good night's sleep on hard cold concrete. We don't have a radio, so we don't know what's going on in the city. We have a few books. A good book to help us forget the horrors of war. Staying here is better than living in a complete room. We lack coffee and cigarettes. We have breaches in the walls. Our shelter is not safe. Yeah, but we don't have any materials to fucking build it up. The trader is here. Yes. Okay. Katia has bargaining skills, so unfortunately we are going to have to get her up. Go answer the door. Katia, come on. We have to go answer the door and see if we can get anything off this guy. So this guy's like the roaming trader. So he's quite expensive on a lot of things, but sometimes you have stuff that he really needs. So nothing special, nothing special, nothing common stuff. Common, nothing special, common, common, nothing special, common. Okay, well, we're not using many of these at the moment, so let's see what we can get for three of those. Can we get a bandage? No. Can we get pills? Oh no, they're really expensive, apparently. Okay, well, let's try getting materials then. With that, let's see if we can push it a little more. See what we can take in terms of wood. No, so that's a little too much. Quite common, quite common. You can have a woman. See if I can tack a little bit. Okay, so that seems to be the most we can get. Let's give one of these back. Okay, deal. Hell with it. Need anything else? No. Goodbye. Thank. Nope. No, go in and close the door, you silly mare. Close the door. And there we go. How's Roman doing? No, Roman, come on. I know you're tired, buddy. But we gotta get this stuff. The door is locked, but I have something to take care of that. Well, use it then. Oh. Okay, so I don't have another. I thought I had two lockpicks. Oh, it got stolen. Okay. Man, this is a lot harder using my non-favorite team. I mean, there are worse starting couples to have. We don't have enough for a bed. We have enough for a radio. Water filter, I guess that's pretty important. Let's make one of those. Maybe pop it in the kitchen? No, it doesn't want to go up there. doesn't want to go in there. Might have to chuck it in this room here. Please. I know you're tired, Roman. I'm very sorry. I've been playing, so we're into day 3. We've been playing for half an hour now, so the days are about, you know, 8 to 10 minutes long, I guess. We'll play for another 10 minutes or so, just in the hopes that I can get to the hospital, so I can show you guys that and get Katia in useful working order. Okay, I need to make a filter for the water, because obviously we are using rainwater, so we're going to have to filter it. And we do have enough stuff for that, luckily. I know you need some rest, I'm sorry. But we also need some water. I can hear him huffing. There you go. So, apparently that should make 4 water for us, which is good. And then what I'll do, because Catty is obviously in bed, I'll just sit him down. Seems to be the next best thing I can offer him at the moment. It's not the most comfortable chair in the world, but, you know, it's better than nothing. Maybe he can, I don't know, read a book. You know, I'm amazed there's no bed, like, existing in this whole house. Like, there's a bedroom, but there's no bed in it. It's easier to fall ill when it's so cold. It's not that cold, buddy. It's 13 degrees. It could be far worse. Jeez. Oh gosh. Slightly sick. Severely wounded. Sad and hungry. Ugh, let's just end the day. This is getting awful. Hospital? Hospital? Maybe? No? Oh. Well, he's gonna pass out, so just gonna have to deal, I guess. Oh great, day 4, outbreak of crime. Katia has some ugly wounds. It seems very serious. Roman's feeling much better. Just have to keep an eye on him. Well, does that mean he's unwell? Oh no, he's just sad and tired. Well, okay, could be worse then. Okay, so if we make some fuel... Oh no, we'll have to use some books to make some fuel. But hey, we got 2. So, that's fine. We'll make a proper meal. And hopefully that will deal with his very hungriness. Oh god damn it, we don't have enough water to make 2 bowls at once. We'll just have to make the 1. Sorry, Katia, but needs must. He's still tired as well, which ain't great. Is there any more rummaging we can do? We can rummage up there, I guess. Wouldn't mind another helping. I know you wouldn't, buddy, but... Right, up to the upper floor then. Let's get this cleared. And hopefully we'll get something out of the cupboard there. Don't think. Have we been in these wardrobes? Are they rummageable? No, apparently not. It's locked! God damn it. Right. Okay. Back down we go. Been through all those. There's no back garden in this one. Okay, so we can't make anything. Awesome. Can't make anything. Awesome. Can't get through that door. Can't get into there. We are screwed. Oh, bio. I must get some food. At all costs. Gotta think of a way to do it. Katia has nothing to say. Oh, hello. Got a proposition for you. Okay. Hey. Hey there. You're new here, aren't you? Yes. Hey there, neighbour. You aren't from around here, are you? I come to tell you that there's an abandoned house nearby. The owners fled the city long ago while it was still possible. If you help me get inside, we might find something of value there. What do you say? I've got nothing else to do here, so I might as well say yes. Let's go then. And then I'm going to end the day because Katia's not going to be doing anything. She's still severely wounded. Oh god, we've done so little scavenging. Stay. What the heck was that? We've been raided. Did Katia die? Oh shit. Oh my god. Okay, so we brought back some tobacco leaves and sugar. They stole all our food, some herbs, and one of our books. Okay, so they basically killed Katia. That's what that noise was. So now he's going to be sad. I don't want to end up like Katia. There's got to be ways to secure more supplies. Damn bandits, we should get some guns and kill the motherfuckers. I don't disagree, buddy. I don't disagree. Okay, well, he needs some sleep. That's for damn sure. God, so what a waste that was. We lost more than we gained. We lost a teammate. I mean, the only advantage to that is that now there's only one of us to feed. But it does mean that we can't have someone working through the day, then someone else scavenging at night. Oh, you can see what sort of game this is. Wow. I'm just going to end the day and go scavenging. Military outpost? No, we are not going there. The ruined block of fats had no food left. We need food. Sniper Junction. Oh, we're going to have to give it a go. It's got food. I'm going to take this one food item with me so that it can't be stolen. Ugh, we're doing so badly. I say we. I'm doing so badly. Hey, buddy. Watch out, you don't want to get shot by the sniper. You're right, I don't. Okay, so there's a ton of materials there. Oh, I don't really need to take it yet, actually. That's by my exit, so I'll grab it on the way back. More materials? Okay. Then what you do is wait till he's shot and run. Run again. Please help me. Give me a sec, bro. Okay, nothing there. Sniper shot me. You're lucky he didn't kill me. I was going home with medicine for my boy when I was sick. Oh god. Okay. I wanted to use the sewers, but someone blocked the entrance. Please, can you do something about it? Probably not, mate. Is there anything over here for me to scav? I guess we can give it a go. I haven't found any freaking food down here. I bet this door's closed. Fuck. Oh man. No way we're getting through there. Need a crowbar or whatever to get through that. If I tried to run for it, I'm dead. Well, run. Oh shit. I just got shot. Is there anything over there? Can I get in this door? Okay, there's movement. But I've got no idea of knowing what that movement is. Is it a person? No, it's rats. That's fine. I can handle rats. Force the locks open with my tools. What tools? Okay, let's go down here. Can't believe he got shot and he just like, yeah, it's cool. Shit ton of materials. Okay, so if I get the door open, that guy will survive, because he can sneak out using the sewers. Let's just scab this food. There's a shit ton of materials here. Crazy amounts of materials. I mean, if I grab all these, I'm set for life. Let's pull these off, and then I can go up and say to him, hey, bro, it's safe to get into the house through the sewers and things. Okay. Did I just hear him open that door? You did, sir. You did. Can I talk to him? Come with me, I'll try to repay you somehow. Okay. Seems, come on then, repay me. Okay, he's just kind of hobbling. Understandable, he's been shot in the leg. Oh gosh, we're running out of time, sir. Come on. Follow me, I have a flat nearby. Is it this flat that I've been scavenging in? Almost there, I just hope my boy is fine. Guessing he's in one of these locked rooms. Oh. Oh god, he's got a baby! Thank god I helped him. I think I'll have something for you. Oh well. Okay, well, thank god we didn't rob this guy. There's a box beneath the bed. Take as much as you need. Wow. Underneath this bed? Cool. I don't want to think about what would happen if it wasn't you. Well, your baby would have died. Oh my shit! So many jewels! Can we open this door? No, it's locked. That's fine. I mean, we have no use for jewellery, so we can just straight up trade that. Okay, can't get through that door because we need a hacksaw, but we can rummage through this crap. Shit ton of materials. Let's take some anyway. Because we are running out of time. And we've got to run to the exit before the day ends, otherwise you get stuck out all night, which is super dangerous. And more materials! Okay, well, I guess that could have been worse. We're now gonna have to leg it. So we'll go this way. Go all the way back that way. But we can get to the top side without being seen for the first half. And if we stand him here. Yes, we know. Right, wait for the guy to shoot. Run. And wait. And run. Cool. Let's quickly grab all and then run. And run to exit. Quick, before the time runs out! Oh, that was so close. So, yeah, this is pretty much the basic premise of the game. Oh, loading. Day 6. I think these loading screens are new with the background images. I'm home, he says to no one. Where did he put the body? Of course, the night's been calm when, you know, he has no one here who needs looking after. But yeah, there we go. Oh, he's got something in his bio. So hungry, I'd kill for a can of meat. I hope that sniper will burn in hell. How can he shoot civilians and stand to look at his own face in the mirror? Well, there you go. So, that is this war of mine. I hope you enjoyed it. It's a really great game. Once you get the hang of things and you know what each character's individual skills are, it's really good to build a custom game and make your own dream team, like I do when I try and play the game on easy mode, essentially. So yeah, I really recommend giving it a go. I'll leave a link to this game in the Steam store, or you might even be able to buy it direct from the developers, I'll check. I'll leave links in the description so that you can check it out yourself. And I really hope you enjoyed this game as much as I do, because I freaking love this game. Thanks very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Take care.